Good morning. We are seeing how a country book is made using a plan. When books are to be manufactured, burned in large scale, continuously, a continuous burning process and a semi-continuous or intermittent burning process are in practice. These chambers where they will be laid in particular fashion, the chambers will be in particular fashion. The factory made bricks are using, instead of clamp, they are using kiln, K-I-L-N. Even though it is K-I-L-N, kiln, usually we call it as kiln. The continuous kiln is half man's kiln. So it will produce continuously the bricks. A semi-continuous or intermittent kiln is called bull trench kiln. So you have two types, bull trench kiln and Hoffman's kiln. Hoffman's kiln will be in circular in shape, almost circular in shape, whereas bull trench kiln will be elliptical in shape. There will be preheating process, there will be burning, continuous burning, heating up of the bricks in different chambers. The bricks will be in different chambers during the process. Ultimately, it will come as a burned brick. After conservation of heat is possible. Suppose you are using kilns, both in bull trench kiln as well as in Hoffman's kiln. The heat can be preserved and used for preheating the brick before it is actually subjected to burn. That is advantage of kiln. There will be lot of energy saved. In clam, the firewood consumption will be more and it will produce lot of carbon dioxide. That's a disadvantage of clam. Lot of smoke avoided. The clam is not properly covered with the mud with sufficient thickness. Protections are not taken. According to the species of the timber, poor quality timbers we use, lot of smoke will come out. Here you have chimney, wood trench. So that's what my chimney, you have chimney, but anyway, carbon, but wherever you have a burning process, that is the disadvantage. The atmosphere will get the share of carbon dioxide. And so as far as sustainability is concerned, brick burning is not advantageous. So usually this brick burning process will be done on open areas. On thickly populated area, you cannot see any kilns or plants. They will be at usually rural areas or outskirts, very far from the urban areas. Large areas will be there. And another location priority is near the riverside. Usually, brick making process and burning process will be near river sides, because there is sand, there is water. Water and sand, water in plenty and sand in particular quantity is required for brick making. Both are available, so usually the brick making process will be near the river sides. And good clay also available near the river side. In rural areas, in villages, from paddy fields, people collect the brick clay, brick earth. The brick clay is called brick earth. So once the burning process is over, the minimum time is 7 days. 7 to 10 days you have to burn. The brick has to be subjected to around 900 degree to 1000 degree. Just see the amount of heat required to burn the raw brick earth, to get a brown red color of the brick. Usually in the clam, bricks are arranged in rows and columns, giving sufficient gaps between each brick to see that the heat is obtained to all the surfaces. As you have seen the stacking on shades, clamp also you have to stack in such a way that the heat from the fireplaces generated will be spreading all over the sides and surfaces of the brick till the bottom to the top. Usually a clamp will be having a size of around 4 to 5 meter high, 10 to 12 meter size as a square. Usually a square 12 meter to 10 to 12 meters and 4 meters, 3 to 4 meters high. So 1 meter cube brick occupies 500 numbers. 500 numbers of brick is required for 1 meter cube. Suppose you just take 10 by 10 by 3 as a clamp. 10 into 10, 100 into 3, 300 meter cube. You have to leave some space for say around 60 centimeters. 10 by 10 by 0.6. So 100.6, 60 meter cube. 100 into 0.6, 60 meter cube. So out of 300 meter cube, 60 meter cube will go for the fireplace. Let us see, complete space will not go. Even then the brick near the fireplaces will not be recommended for construction. So you have 300 minus 60, 240, let us say 250 meter cube. So 250 into 500, that's a rough approximate number of bricks, roughly 250 into 500, 200 into 500 is 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh. So more than a lakh of bricks you get, even if it is 200 meters. Now you have 50 more, 25,000, so 1 lakh 25,000 bricks you get easily. Within 7 days, 7 to 10 days time, the continuous burning. So you should go on feeding firewood. This 10 meter will be there will be fireplaces having an opening of say 40 to 45 centimeter running throughout in both directions. All the sides will have this, just like a heating platform. So this brick, after burning, when you take out the brick, giving sufficient time for quenching. Quenching means reducing the heat because the brick will be very hot, so some aeration will be there after the burning process. After the firewoods have burnt fully, you give some sufficient time, 3 to 4 or 5 days, then only that heat which is accumulated there will get dissipated and the bricks will be cooled down. We cannot use water at that time to cleanse. Air cleansing. After 7 days, 10 days, a rain comes, that will not be a problem. But during the process of the 7 days, the rain comes, that will considerably affect the quality of bricks. Usually, nowadays you have sheds. Clamps are made under open sheds with the roof, temporary sheds, because as you have again the climate change, nobody is sure when the rain will come. So to protect that, in the case of Hoffmannskin and Bultrangini, there are post chambers. So the problem of rain will not be that much there. So after cooling down, the brick will be taken out. The bricks which are very near rows and columns of bricks which are near the fireplaces will be overheated. So those bricks are called overburned bricks. So one category is overburned brick near the fireplaces. Then you have a stretch of row and column of bricks which will be well burned in between. Well burned brick. If unscientific height is increased in the case of a clamp, and if the heat is not sufficiently reaching there, the top part, it will be underburned. Suppose the bricks are underburned at the top layer, they will be again laid in the next clamp to reuse the brick, because it will be a severe loss. Underburned bricks cannot be used for anything, so it has to be reheated. Overburned bricks will be used for water lining, sides of the well. When you dig open wells, the sides have to be protected. In the ancient days, now you have other methods of lining the open wells, but it is better to line a well with open jointed overburned bricks. Well jointed overburned bricks with open joints to allow the spring of water from the sides to come and recoup the well, recharge the well. Overburned bricks will be used for open well lining. Well burned bricks will be used for construction. Best brick for construction is the well burned brick. Underburned brick will be used for absorbing water wherever you want to absorb water, such as the soap pit. Soap pit is the next component of a septic tank. The water after the decomposition process, digestion process, water will come out of the septic tank. That water will go into a circular pit having sufficient diameter and depth, known as the soap pit. Usually this soap pit will be filled with underburned bricks. If underburned broken bricks are put there, they will absorb this water, so that the soap pit can be used for a longer period. Overburned brick, well burned brick, and underburned brick. Well burned brick itself, you have classes as first class brick one. First class brick, second class. So see, according to the quality of the brick, the best quality conforming to all standards or specification is called the first class brick. Thank you. God bless.